church without end. And somebody said, amen. Amen has entered your house. Amen has entered your heart. This is your moment of might, your moment of might. I see amen written on your forehead. I see amen on your way. Step amen. Amen. As you are walking, one, two, one, two. Amen. 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 Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Tell the Lord, amen. 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 This is the moment. This is the moment of his might, the moment of his power, the moment of his provision, and the moment of your miracle. It's doing it tonight. It's doing it tonight. It's doing it tonight. It's doing it tonight. It's your moment. It's your moment. This moment will not pass you by. It will forgive your sin. This moment will not pass you by. It will break every chain, every shackle in your life. This moment will not pass you by. It will heal your sickness. He'll provide for you. All those giants are canceled. All the gods of the land against your life, all of them, they are brought down tonight. All of them, they are brought down tonight. There's an amen in your life. Amen, so let it be. Amen, so let it be. Any sin you confess tonight, it will forgive. Any sin you confess tonight, it will forgive. Any sin you confess tonight, it will forgive. It's the moment of his might. It's the moment of his might. It's the moment of his might. Tell him, tell him, tell him. Tell him, tell him. The moment of your joy. The moment of your happiness. The moment of your inheritance. The moment of your deliverance. The moment of your dominion. Tell him, you have it tonight. You have it tonight. You have it tonight. This is the moment. It will not pass you by. It will not pass you by. It will not pass you by. Joy, happiness, glory, grace, gift, goodness, healing, deliverance. It will not pass you by. This is the moment. This is your moment. The moment of his might. The moment of his might. He answers every prayer tonight. He answers every prayer tonight. He answers every prayer tonight. He'll cleanse your heart. He'll change your life. He'll transform you completely. This is the moment. It's the moment of your victory. It's the moment of your victory. Giants will fall. The giants will fall. The giants are conquered tonight. All those gods, all those idols, all those magicians, they fall before you tonight. And the giant of infirmity, and the giant of sickness, and the giant of long-standing mountain, all those things are gone. They are gone. They are gone. They are gone tonight. You'll walk over them. You'll trample over them. Victory for me. Victory for me. Victory for me. Victory. Victory. Success. Abundance. Joy. You conquer tonight. You conquer tonight. You conquer tonight. It's there. The victory is so nearby. Stretch out your hand and get it. Stretch out your hand and receive it. He gives you tonight. Success. All those things standing in your way, they remove tonight. Remove tonight. The adversaries are conquered. The adversaries are destroyed. Open doors before you. Doors of opportunity before you. And doors of prevailing before you. Now you can move on. And now you can make progress. And now you can leave all those paths of darkness behind you. And now you can rise up and walk. Now you can open those eyes and see. Now you have all all the inheritance of heaven available for you. And he says, rise up and walk. Rise up and succeed. Rise up and make progress. Rise up and move the mountain. Say to that mountain, say to that mountain, say to that mountain, be thou removed. And it is gone. It is gone. It is gone. Tell him, tell him, tell him. Every prayer you pray here tonight is answered. Every proclamation we make here tonight is fulfilled. All the giants we come against tonight, they're destroyed. The powers of their gods, the authority of their gods, and the magic of their talisman, tonight, 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 destroyed, destroyed, destroyed. Infirmity gone. Impotence gone. It's gone. It's gone. Now you are complete. Now you are complete. Now you are complete. All the adversaries against your way, against your progress, all the adversaries stopping you, they come in the dream, they come in the day. They come through so-called friends, and they come sometimes directly like an enemy. And you stand tonight like a militant soldier of the cross. And whatever you say to those adversaries tonight, they're defeated and conquered tonight. Doesn't matter how long the problem has been there, 38 years, they're going tonight. 40 years, infirmity is going tonight. 60 years of an adversary is conquered tonight. And a nothingness, and a nothingness, and a nothingness. I have nothing. I hold nothing. I see nothing. I keep nothing. Everything is empty. Everything has been vacant. Tonight, there's divine supply. That giant of nothingness is canceled tonight. Canceled. Canceled. Destroyed. One stone out of five will bring that Goliath down today. One prayer tonight will bring those giants down. Rise up and move. Leave all the fears behind you. Leave all the littleness of faith behind you. And leave all the faithlessness behind you. And just understand that now with the might of the Almighty, you're moving on, you're moving on, you're moving on, and you're going to conquer. There's no doubt about it. There's a surely, surely, surely. He is my God. Surely, through him I conquer. Surely, through him I overcome. You overcome tonight without a shadow of doubt. This is your day. This is your moment. The moment of his might. The moment of his might. Victory tonight. Dominion tonight. Salvation tonight. Holiness tonight. Sanctification tonight. Power tonight. Firepower. Firepower tonight that will burn every chaff out of your life. The moment of his might. It's happening. It's happening right there. It's happening right there. Sorrow is gone. Depression is gone. Suicide spirit is driven away. Free. Free. Victorious tonight. Victorious tonight. Having dominion tonight. Unconquerable power tonight. Every prayer that you pray tonight is answered. Tell him. Every promise you claim tonight is granted. Tell him. Every decree you make tonight is confirmed. Tell him. This is your day. Don't miss your chance. This is your day. Don't miss your chance. This is your moment. The moment of manifestation. The moment of miracle. It's the moment of progress. It's your hour. Claim it. Stand on it. Believe it. It's done. You feel the guilt of sin over there? Tell him, grace is available here tonight. Abundant grace here tonight. Sufficient grace here tonight. Exceedingly abundant grace here tonight. He forgives. He saves. He reconciles. He reconciles unto God. He enables us. And he gives us the power to go and sin no more. Is there tonight? Sickness will not abide. Sickness will not remain. Infirmity will not remain. Poverty will not remain. Barrenness will not remain, will not abide. What to say tonight that you are requesting from God? Every prayer tonight is answered. Accept the answer. Believe the answer. Confess the answer. You'll see the manifestation. The gift of God, abundant. The gift of God, sufficient. The gift of God, greater than your need. Available tonight. You're possessed tonight. Hold on to it tonight. Whatever you're asking the Lord, whatever you're asking the Lord, is granted freely. Granted fully. Granted sufficiently. Completely tonight. Completely tonight. This is the hour. This is the moment. The hour of his power. The moment of his might. Accept it done. Believe it's done. Hold fast. Hold fast. The confidence you have in the Almighty. Don't give in. Don't give up. Hold it fast. It's done. Hold it fast. It's done. The answer has come. Manifestation in your life. Miracle in your life. The supernatural power of God in your life. Count it done. Count it done. It's done. It's done. It's done. Thank him. Praise him. I have unshakable confidence It's done. There's an amen now in your life. Amen in your heart. Amen to your prayer. The Lord has answered you. The Lord has answered you. The Lord has answered you. Amen. In your heart, amen. On your way, amen. In your family, amen. Against every giant in your life, amen. The promise is fulfilled. The miracle is performed. The answer is given. Give an amen you are going to take back home. It's done. It's done. It's done. In Jesus' name we pray. Raise up the victorious hand. The hand of dominion. The hand of victory. The hand of success. Whatever this hand touches will turn to prosperity. Whatever this hand touches will drive away every giant. You are getting to the promised land. I see the brightness on your face already. The joy, the excitement on your face already. I see the face of an achiever there. The face of a conqueror there. I rejoice with you. From this moment of his might, things in your life will never be the same again. Keep those hands up, Father, in Jesus' name. We thank you for this glorious day. The day and the moment and the hour of your power and your might. Everyone here tonight, every prayer they have prayed, give an amen from heaven in Jesus' name. Lord, to every brother here, to every sister here, to every boy, every girl here, let the angels give an amen to their prayer. Lord, I pray. All the powers of the gods of the heathen, they're broken out today in Jesus' name. Infirmity, impotence, sickness, weakness, demonic attack, go out in Jesus' name. Incurable disease, incurable sickness, we reject them tonight. In this moment of his might, be healed in Jesus' name. Brain problem and insanity, madness running in the family, all those psychological problems, be delivered in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray every adversary and every enemy that has followed anyone here, and they cannot achieve, they could not achieve, they could not make progress. Adversaries, you are conquered in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray. This state of having nothing, no work, no child, no wife, no husband, no prospect, nothing. And this nothing from year to year has been like a giant. Lord, I pray, cancel nothingness in Jesus' name. Abundant supply. Abundant supply. To take care of your life. To take care of your family. To take care of your children. To live a happy life. Lord, I pray, abundant supply in every life in Jesus' name. divine provision of prosperity, surplus, sufficiency in your life in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that the giant of terror, the giant of trouble, the giant of trials, the giant of Mr. Terrible, Mrs. Terrible, running after them. Mr. Terrible, I command you, get out in Jesus' name. And Lord, I pray for every child of God here. Every form of fear that gives you a setback, I cancel that fear in Jesus' name. Lord, all the storms in their lives, my brother there, my sister there, my child, my daughter there, storm, 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 be calm in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, open the windows of heaven upon everyone here tonight, without exception. Open the windows of heaven. Shower it down. Blessing, shower it down. Provision, shower it down. Salvation, shower it down. Victory, shower it down. Oh, Lord, breakthrough, shower it down. Testimonies over there. Testimonies over there. Testimonies over there. Oh Lord, I pray this will be the moment of turning around of every life. It is done. It is done. It is confirmed. Confirm each and every life in Jesus' name. And grant everyone here tonight a testimony. Thank you, Lord, because we know it is happened. We thank you because we know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. Any amen there? Amen on the road. Amen in the way. Amen in the night. Amen in the day. Amen from heaven upon your life.
Praise the Lord! Wait, everybody. No movement now. We are going to celebrate Christ. He has done it for me. Has he done for you? Has he done anything for you? Bye-bye, Tore de Rede. Bye-bye, Tore de Rede. In the name of Jesus, a new life. In the name of Jesus. Wait. You have to clap your hands. We are giving testimony tonight because God has touched you. I say God has touched you. We are going to celebrate our victory. Brother Victor, are you going to do it? Sister Victoria, are you going to do it? Everybody should celebrate tonight. You are not going anywhere. He has done for me. He has done for me. What my brother cannot do. What my people cannot do. He has done for me. If he has done it for you, can you come at least give testimony? We are waiting for your testimony. God has taught you. Don't be an ingrate. Come and give your testimony. Sing aloud. He has done for me. Please come to the choir stand. We are expecting. We are waiting for you. God has taught us tonight. He has done it for you. He has done it for me. He has done it. Sing aloud. He has done it. He has done for me. Let's celebrate the downfall of infirmity. Let's celebrate the downfall of adversity. Sing aloud. He has done it for you. No more nothingness in your life. Celebrate. We are free from the hand of Mr. Terror. No more storm in your home. He has done it for us. We are waiting for you. Come and share your testimony. We are celebrating. We are celebrating tonight. He has done it tonight. Sing aloud. He has done it for you. He has done it for me. Let's celebrate. You have a testimony. We are waiting for you. Near the pulpit by my left. This is a jubilating time, celebration time. Don't go, listen to the testimony. Because you are going to give your testimony. If you have just received miracle, we are waiting for you. Sing it aloud, he has done it. Oshé, Oshé. Just receive your miracle and you are listening to us on the radio or television. Please share your testimony with us via the WhatsApp number +234 915 444926. Let's celebrate. Anywhere you are in the globe, and God has taught you, please come out. Share your testimony with us through our WhatsApp number +234 915 444 9263 or the link gckhq.org/testimony being displayed on the screen. You can also record a video of your testimony and share with us via our WhatsApp and Telegram. Brethren, let's celebrate. God has done wonder tonight. What manner of God we are serving. He has visited us today. We are going to celebrate. Say the downfall of Satan, glory be. Have you seen the downfall of Satan? Sing out. I have seen, say the downfall of Satan, glory be to God. March on him. You have seen the downfall of Satan. The giant of infirmity has been fallen. The adversary has departed from your way. No more nothingness in your life. Mr. Terror, Mrs. Terror, we are going to fear you now. No more storm. If you have seen the downfall of Satan, sing it aloud. Jubilee, let's celebrate. We have seen the downfall of Satan. Jesus is the winner. Answer. Are you a winner? If you are a winner, can you not sing? We are waiting for your testimony. Please come out and share the testimony. Better, but you can do more than that. Praise the Lord! You know, the downfall of Satan you witness tonight shall be perpetual downfall. I said it will be perpetual downfall in Jesus' name. We want to listen to testimony now. You can be seated. We are not in hurry tonight. We want to celebrate openly the downfall of the devil. You are about to listen to the testimony of others. It's a matter of time. You will give your own testimony. What do I say? You will give your own testimony. We shall start now.
The Lord. My name is Dr. Peter Obwane, medical practitioner. Here before me is Brother Samuel. He wants to share his testimony. Let's listen to him.
People of God, praise the Lord. My name is Ayafulu Samuel. I'm here to testify for the grace of God in my life. This evening, I just said, like, I want to shave my body parts. But as I shave it finish, I was experiencing pain, like something tricking my body. But I felt that it's a normal thing for young people. But I discovered that it's good to a point that I'll be still feeling injury in my body. But I believe that tonight, God has done it for me. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Our brother was experiencing excruciating pain. But this evening, in response to the prayer of faith, the Lord made him whole instantaneously. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Devil is in trouble. What do I say? In your life, devil is what? Globally now, there's celebrations. We want to listen to online testimony now.
Is to have a healthy son, not the one battling with any health challenge. I discovered sometime along the line when he was a year plus that he's having difficulty in breathing whenever he's sleeping. He will make some noisy sounds, snoring and whistling and all the rest. in July last year when I visited the hospital, and they now send us for an x-ray which indicate that there is an obstruction in his airway passage, and it requires surgery, which will cost me 200,000. Whenever Pastor Kumuyi comes up for the miracle prayers, I will tell him to raise up his one hand, then lay the other one on his nostril, which he did. No more noisy breathing, no more whistling. Now I can sleep very well, because initially it has been giving me sleepless nights, but now that he's calm and free from all those symptoms, I myself, I have my peace of mind. Praise the Lord.
I'm Mrs. Johnny Mary. This is my little kid sister here. Yeah? She's promised a Efuriere. It all started 2011 when she was born. She was confirmed SX when she was a year plus. I used to encourage her to come to crusade with me. She'd be writing a prayer request that God should turn her SS to AA. So in showers of blessing, she all through the stress of the rehearsals, I noticed it. She was just having the energy to go through. Then the publicity, all her life, she has never trekked such a distance. And she trekked that distance. I was observing her, there was no crisis. So all through that showers of blessing, she didn't have issues. So by the time showers of blessing came to an end, I was just observing her. So a few days after, when I want to go and do the test, she broke down. But what I noticed, we put it in a scale of 100, it was as if 60% was gone. It was not bad. It was as if she was just having normal malaria. So after that showers of blessing, Yola Crusade came. In that Yola Crusade, because when she wants to go for that crusade, she will write in a prayer request, SS to AA. So I saw her that in that Yola Crusade, she raised up that prayer request up. And she was just crying as Jesus was praying. So after the Yola Crusade, she just came to me boldly that let's go and check her genotype. I said, this one, yeah. He said, I'm feeling it. It's not only I'm feeling it. Everything in me has changed. I'm feeling it. I hold my body. I'm feeling it. I said, okay, we will go. We went to do the test. And lo and behold, SS turned to AA.
My name is Promise Fiery. I want to give glory to God for changing my genotype from SS to AA. Those past years have been years of pain all over my body, but I want to give glory to God for taking away my pain at home. Praise the Lord.
My name is Okokwinime. Early last year, February precisely, I noticed that one part of my legs, the left side of my legs, was having weaknesses, that it was giving me challenge from walking freely. I had to go for a medical checkup, which I did. I ran a test, and they told me that I have cold in my system, that I should avoid any cold things. If I'm taking cold water or anything, I should avoid, which I did. But in the drugs that was given, as I was taking it, it was increasing, like the effect of my healing wasn't there. It has to go to the other side of my legs, that both legs became paralyzed. I had to return back to the hospital. That was April, to tell them that this is what I am facing. So then I was being taken care by my caregiver, who took me down there to see the doctor. The doctor told me that my blood system is not flowing well and the cartridges were weak, so I can't walk, that I need a therapy to work on me. The challenge became worse, that the whole of my system was numb. The legs, the hand, even my chest was not having this big stone that was so heavy. I could not breathe. I couldn't move my body. I can't even turn if I sleep on the bed. I cannot even lay on the bed on my own, neither can I stand up on my own. All this process, this was the whole challenge I went through. A caregiver was the one feeding me, taking care of me. If I want to ease myself and all that, they carry me from one position to another. Come November crusade, prayers were on. I wasn't there present, but my mom was there praying on my behalf. And at God we have it, one faithful Friday morning, I was able to raise myself from the bed for the first time in 7 months, which I haven't done. My legs were strengthening, my chest that was heavy, the whole numbness in my body were becoming light. And today, I am telling you that that same person that was unable to do anything to help herself, could not walk, could not do all things by herself, the hands that was numb are now free. Praise God. the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let me ask you a question. Do you believe that we are like Pastor W. Ekumoyi? We. That is talking to you now. The Spirit of God wants me to tell you that as you waited now, listen, you are going to receive extra. Happy listening.
Praise the Lord. Here with me is Brother Chuku Peter. He has a testimony to share with us.
Praise the Lord. I really have to share this one because the devil has been trying to discourage me from letting people know what God has done for me. My life has been wayward for the past 7 years since I left my parents' home and wandering on the streets trying to become a man on my own. And it was full of sorrow and pain and shame. Until I came back home with a severe sickness that was pneumonia that left my life for over 15 years. And it came back around ending of November, or third week of November last year. So I called my parents and told them I was coming home, and they told me to come home. And I came back home and attending to the Bible study, Sunday worship service. It was on the 11th of December 2023, that was last year. Pastor Kumi gave a message on accepting the truth, buying the truth and selling it not. So that was the night within me was really burning. Like, I couldn't hold it within me anymore. I had to confess and tell God, this is me, just do whatever you want to do with me. So that was the night I surrendered everything and promised I won't go back to, because my life, think about any kind of sin, yes, I was involved in it. So I told God I won't go back to any of those things. And since then, he has been helping me, keeping me. I've been saved and experiencing the joy of his salvation. Praise the Lord.
The Lord. Here is Sister Chinyere Oluwasegun. She has come to share what God did for her this very night. Let's listen to her.
Praise the Lord! Praise the living Jesus! My name is Sister Chinyere Oluwasegun. I want to bless the name of the Lord for the salvation of my soul. I was a sinner coming to this church, even though I was very young when I started this church, though I was not born again. There was a day that Pastor Kumi was preaching a message, remember, in the church. That day I wept. That message touched me. I really cried like a baby. Said if I end my life in a sinful way, where am I going to be? That means I'll go to hellfire. But I thank God because God saved me. Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. 5 years ago, I did VG. I prayed. After praying, I slept off. So when I slept, I just noticed that somebody slapped me. Invisible hand slapped me. I woke up and I was sleeping with my daughter, my small daughter then. She was like 6 years old. But the hand I felt was the hand of an adult. So I said, who slapped me? I didn't see anybody. It was in the middle of the night. So since then, I've been experiencing hotness of the body. in my ear hotness. It will be as if they pour pepper in my body. So some month, last month, it started again. I was still feeling it. When it starts, I can't tell anybody. But I used to pray to God that, God, remove this problem. It will be as if one side of me wants to be paralyzed. So even when it started today, I was contemplating whether to come. Devil did not want me to come. But I'm the type that when I determine that I'm going to do something, I normally do it. So I determined and I came. When I came, pastor was preaching. I was really connected with the preaching. So when the prayer started, I prayed like a wounded lion. So when the pastor was rounding up the prayer, it's as if they pour ice water on me. And I felt relieved. That's why I got my testimony, my healing. Praise the Lord. Also, I want to thank God because that giant of poverty has been removed from my life and my family. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. As you have heard, our sister, she's been having these numerous symptoms in her body for 5 years. But this night, the Lord healed her instantaneously. Praise the Lord.
Church, what are you getting? Say it louder. Say it again. You are getting extra, and your cough will run over.
Yes, Brother Jeremiah Amakato, who has come to testify of what God has done for her, for him.
Praise the Lord. I thank God for what he has done for me. Actually, that was 2021 to 2022. I had issues with my health, and the name of the illness was a stroke of the young, which affected my brain, and I couldn't talk. But God still helped me. After that, I now had seizures.
First and third Thursdays of every month in this 2024 season for a night of supernatural wonders. Come, bask in abundance in the mighty works of Jesus at 5:45 p.m. at any Deeper Life location nearest to you. You may just be a praise from your breakthrough. No turning back till the hand of God is upon you. A night where the storms of life dissipate. A night where the captivity of the evil ones are turned away. A night where dry bones receive life and the sick renew strength like the eagles. It is a night where the power of God moves in deepest wonders and might. Join the servant of God, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi, every first and third Thursdays of every month in this 2024 season for a night of supernatural wonders.
It's you. Did you believe it? I said the Lord will visit you. Say to the next person sitting near you, say the Lord will visit you. Let's rest up. It was written in the Bible that it came to pass on a certain day, like today, that Jesus was teaching, and there were Pharisees and doctors of law sitting by, which were come out of every town of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem. And the power of the Lord was present to him. Tonight, the Lord will repeat the same thing that he did at that time, even in your life tonight, in Jesus' name. I want you to say, Lord, we welcome you to this place. Open your mouth and say, Lord, we welcome your presence. Let's welcome the presence of God. He's here already. His power is here already. Let's welcome him. We have an appointment with him. He is a covenant-keeping God. He is the one who invited you and me that we should come today. Let's welcome him. Let's welcome the Spirit of the Lord that tonight will be a remarkable day in your life. It will be a remarkable day in your life and my life. It will be a remarkable day in our church. Open your mouth and welcome the Holy Ghost. Welcome the Father. Welcome the Son. Welcome the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth and begin to say, Lord, we welcome you. Father, we welcome you. Son, Jesus, we welcome you. Holy Ghost Divine, we welcome you. The power of God is here already. And to heal and to deliver, you are going to be partaker of that miracle tonight. Welcome the Holy Ghost into our midst. Let's bless the name of the Lord. For what he's going to do tonight, God is going to do something incredible, wonderful, marvelous in your life, in my life. Open your mouth and say, Lord, we thank you for what you are going to do tonight. God is going to do something. Open your mouth and begin to worship the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. His presence is already here. If you are just entering and you have special striking testimony, please, we are expecting you where the choir is seated. Please come there so that you can have the privilege of sharing your testimony. The Lord has been marvelous, wonderful in our church. Let's thank him for what he's going to do tonight. It's an appointment we have with God. Tonight, it's going to be an unforgettable day in your life. Tonight is going to be an unforgettable day in your life. Open your mouth and say, Lord, I welcome you. Holy Ghost Divine, I welcome you. Spirit of the Lord, I welcome you. God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, we welcome you into our midst tonight. As you are coming in, you have testimony. Please come to this left side of the pulpit where the choir is seated so that we can interview you. Brethren, God is going to visit us today. It's a day that you will never forget. It's going to be a memorable day, unforgettable day. The power of God is going to work wonders, supernatural wonders, in your life, in my life. Open your mouth and say, Lord, I welcome you. The Spirit of the living God is moving around. He's going to touch you. Begin to say the Lord, Lord, I know you are going to visit me today. You are going to touch me today. The presence of Almighty is already here. Let's welcome him. Let's bless the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Our blessed Redeemer, King of Glory, according to the scripture, we know that you are here already. And you are going to touch us individually. And there's going to be shout of joy and gladness in our midst tonight in Jesus' name. No one will go back empty-handed today in Jesus' name. You are going to do incredible, something unforgettable. And it's going to be on everyone that is present here today in Jesus' name. Continue with us, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Please, once again, if you have a testimony to share, please, we expect you by my side, left side here. Please come there so that we can interview you. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. I would like us all to rise up on our feet, as this is yet another time of supernatural wonder, supernatural victory, supernatural testimony, supernatural increase, supernatural wonders, supernatural joy. Shout supernatural wonder, supernatural victory.
Oh, Lord, my God.
Glory be to the Lord in the highest. Everybody shout hallelujah. Everybody shout hallelujah. Everybody shout hallelujah.
Yeah.
Shall you make this confession of faith that tonight is my night? Say it louder. God will touch you. I say, God will touch you. Open your mouth and say, Lord, pass me no by. Touch me tonight. Touch me tonight. Change my destiny tonight for good. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and say, Lord, tonight, touch me. Touch me. At the point of my need, oh Lord, touch me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Our God and our Father, we are in your presence. And in your presence, there is fullness of joy. Whoever come here today with sorrow, we go back with joy. I said they will go back with joy in Jesus' name. Lord, make today a remembrance day, an unforgettable day. Thank you, Father. As we are commencing now, we pray that your spirit will lead us. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Another louder amen. We are singing from the program sheet. Have you got your program sheet? Now we are singing page 2. Running over. Your call will run over tonight. Since the Savior came to these hearts of mine, my call filled and run me over. Fill my poor soul with his joy divine. My cause filled and running over. With my Lord so dear, I have not to fear. My cause filled and running over. To my way, though my way may be there, he is ever near. My cause filled and running over. Even though I walk through death's dark storm of life, my cause filled and running over. Christ my Lord shall be my comfort still. My cause filled and running over. Sinner, seek the Lord, trust his precious word, while the angel round you over, heaven bells will ring, and you then will sing, my cause filled and running over, running over, running over, my cause filled and running over. Since the Lord saved me, I am happy as can be, my cause filled and running over.
praise the Lord. Everybody praise the Lord. You are welcome to this great night of supernatural wonders in Jesus' name. We thank God because tonight he is going to use his servant, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi, to bless us tonight. If you believe that, can you say a bigger amen? It is time now to pray for the nations of the world. Let us all rise up as we keep standing. Lift up your voices to God and praise him. Because the Bible says in Psalms 107, verses 1 and 2, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Verse 2 says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he had redeemed from the hand of the enemy. Praise God for his excellent greatness. Can you open your mouth now and pray? Praise God for his mighty works in our midst. Lift up your voices to God. Praise God for his unspeakable gift of salvation through Christ for all people, and his desire and will for all men to be saved. Lift up your voices now. Praise God. Worship him. Express your gratitude to the Almighty because he has saved people, and it is his will that people should be saved. You have to praise God for the efficacious sacrifice of Christ and the power of the gospel to save sinners, the salvation and the preservation of souls that are saved. Can you praise God for that? Can you just appreciate God for that which he has done? Praise God also for his numerous blessings of healing, of provisions, of protection, and deliverance for his people. Can you praise God for that? God is wonderful. God is loving. Are you praying? Pray. Thank God. Worship him. Exalt him for this. Worship God also for our general superintendent and his family. God's sustenance, God's grace, God's anointing, and divine help, as well as the impact of his ministry on the church and the whole world. Is this not praiseworthy? Can we not praise God for this? Look at the great man God has raised for this generation. And God has used him mightily, and mighty things are happening. Praise God also for relative peace and progress in all nations amidst insecurity, wars, and disasters, as well as diseases. Worship God for relative peace and progress. Worship the Lord for that. Lift up his name. Praise him. Worship him for that. Then we should worship God now for preservation and provisions for the church amidst adversities in all nations where the church is found. Just worship the Lord for this great thing he has been doing. Lift up his name. He is God, and he has proven himself great. The Lord is good all the time, and is good to his own people. In Jesus' name we pray. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 25, reading there in verse 7, it says, and he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations. In Psalms 22, verse 27 and 28, the Bible says, all the ends of the world shall remember and turn unto the Lord, and all the kindreds of the nations shall worship before thee. For the kingdom is the Lord's, and he is the governor amongst all nations. Let us pray that God will have mercy upon all people on earth, forgive all iniquities, and heal the world. Open your mouth and pray. This is an important prayer request. Let the Lord forgive. Let the Lord heal the world. Let the Lord forgive of all the bloodshed. Let the Lord forgive of all the tumors caused by men. Let the Lord forgive, and also that the Lord will heal the world. Heal the troubled areas of the world. You know, you are living in part of that world. And as you pray, there is a God that will answer. We want to pray also that God will arise and arrest the hearts of the leaders and citizens of all nations with conviction and the fear of God for repentance and holy life during and after this program. Open your mouth to the Lord and pray that the Lord will arrest all hearts, and He will make all leaders to lead in a sphere. God ruleth, and He is all powerful and almighty. He will lead them to lead in the fear of the Lord. We are going to pray that God will overrule the power of the wicked. Do you hear that? This is something you must take serious. That God will overrule the power of the wicked in all nations and cause the domineering power and evil agenda to break and to scatter in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and take authority. God has given us power. We have the power to root out. We have the power to pull down every stronghold. Open your mouth and pray that God will overrule the power of the wicked. Pray to God that God Almighty will take over all nations and make their leaders do His will in every sphere of life. Grant us lasting peace and prosperity in all nations. Pray. You know, if you can pray, God is going to change situations, because our God answers prayers. We also have to pray that God will bring an end to all civil unrest, all protest in the nations worldwide, that God will console and comfort all those who lost their loved ones and practice to these civil disorders. Pray and talk to the Almighty. He's going to do it. He said, call upon me and I will answer you, and I will do great and mighty things, even more than what you have asked. In Jesus' name we pray. I want to hear a global amen. Can you say a better amen now? Now, decree a dramatic recovery of the economy of all nations. Are you serious? You will be serious with this. Decree, because the Bible says if you decree a thing, it shall be established. Decree a recovery of the economy of all nations. Peace reign over all nations continuously, that God will descend upon all occultic seats in any part of the world and destroy all occultism. Let's go to God in prayer. If you pray, the Lord is going to answer us, and He will do great and mighty things, more than even what we have asked. The Lord is going to do it. In Jesus' name we pray. Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 15 says, and I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. Let us pray that God will grant our general superintendent special anointing, divine and physical strength, with the power to minister throughout this program. Open your mouth and pray for the GS. Pray that the Lord will grant him divine anointing. Pray that there will be unprecedented harvest of healing signs, wonders, and miracles across the nations of the world and beyond during this program. That the GS will enjoy divine utterance throughout the program, and the Lord will confirm the word of God in his mouth, in the mouth of his servant, and with notable and visible, verifiable miracles. Pray that the mighty hand and power will make it impossible for any man, any problem, any negative situation to stand before the general superintendent. Pray that God Almighty will not fail to magnify him before his own eyes and in the eyes of everyone in all nations. Pray that God will stir up his glory upon the GS and cause him to flourish like the palm tree and grow like the cedar in Lebanon. Pray that he will enjoy angelic escort and divine protection in his journeys to and from this program. I want us to pray that God will satisfy him with long life, that God will give him good health, that God will give him strength, that God will give him abundant grace to fulfill his ministry. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to pray now that whatever is your expectation tonight, your expectation will not be cut off. Whatever you have brought as empty basket, the Lord will fill it. If you believe that, say amen. Ask God what you want him to do tonight. Open your mouth and pray. He will do it for you. He will do it for you. In Jesus' name, we pray. I want to hear a global amen. Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you because this is actually going to be a night of supernatural wonders. I pray that every that come here with a request will go back with a satisfactory answer and solution to all problems in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Another amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. You try, but you can do better. Praise the Lord. I stand here tonight to announce to you that you are the next testifier. Who am I talking to? The Lord has answered your prayer. Let's listen to this announcement. You are all welcome to tonight, night of supernatural wonder in Jesus' name. You will be carriers of wonder tonight. And if today is your first time of fellowshipping with us here in Bagada at our international headquarters, kindly identify by raising up your hands. If you are coming here for the first time, can I see your hands up? Can you help me by standing up so that I can identify you and bring our general superintendent special greeting to you? It is well with you in Jesus' name. I say it is well with them in Jesus' name. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. Our GS is very happy to see you in our midst. And he wants me to tell you that you should keep coming so that God will equally use him as he has been using him to bless the brothers and sisters that are seated around you. Our ushers are very close to you. They will give you a piece of paper. Please receive it. Fill all the information required in capital letters and return it back to them. You can be seated in Jesus' name. Now, I want you to listen carefully on our weekly meeting. We have three important weekly meetings in this church. We have Monday Bible study, Thursday revival and evangelism training service, and Sunday inspirational worship. Our visitor, please contact the person that brought you here today. He or she will direct you to the nearest church to your environment where you live. And we also tell you the time of our services. And the Lord will bless you as you join us to worship in our local churches in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. I want to announce to you that Global Crusade is drawing nearer of this month. And the sufficiency of Jesus Christ will be made manifest in our lives this month in Jesus' name. It's a double dose. Global Crusade, GCK, and Easter Retreat comes up from Thursday 28th of March to Tuesday 2nd April 2024. The Alpha location is in Taraba State. And the theme of this program is tied to the all-sufficient Christ. Can you say it again? Repeat it again. That sufficiency of God will be made manifest in our lives this time in Jesus' name. Also be sharing in GCK our ministers and professional conference. It holds on Friday 29 March, Monday 1st, Tuesday 2nd of April 2024. Also we have the Impact Academy. It will hold on Saturday at 8th of March 2024 for teenagers, campus students, and corpus. We must invite the outsiders and also our members. Let's remind them that these are the program scheduled for them so that their destiny will be fulfilled. I pray that this month it's going to be an explosion of power and you are going to catch your miracle. I say you are going to receive your miracle. Let's rise up to give our tithe and offering. Let's rise up, want to give our tithe and offering. As we know that God expects us to give tithe and offering because it was written in the book of the Lord that we should bring all the tithe into the storehouse. And God said, when we do that, He will bless us in return. Can you raise it up? Let us pray. Our blessed Redeemer, we thank you for the blessings of God that make it rich, that added no sorrow unto it. Out of what you have blessed us, we bring this little. Please accept it in Jesus' name. Let it be used for the expansion of your kingdom in Jesus' name. All the givers, in return, you bless them abundantly. And your name be praised. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Please drop your tithe and offering in the bag pass around you. Please, the impact we hold on Tuesday, not Saturday. Please take note of that. It's Tuesday, not Saturday. If you have not yet dropped your offering, raise it up so that our brethren can see you. If you have dropped your offering, you can be seated. But if you have not given your own, remain standing so that they can see you.
We now bring you choir ministry.